It is so difficult to know where I should begin, especially when, unlike you, I already know the ending. But let us say that this story began with the end of another, far, far from the surf of Long Island. For many years, I had absolutely no public life. I had said no to interviews so often it was widely regarded as my forte. Then, just once, on impulse, I said, yes.
Does the 20th century play any part in your life?
I'm sorry?
Do you, for instance, use a word processor?
I'm a writer. I write. I don't process words.
So who do you write for?
Myself.
May I ask why you're here today?
Well, I was wondering that myself, but your colleague was a friend of my late wife who translated for the World Service. And, of course, I do have a faint interest as to how these things are done, you know.
You've never been tempted to write for radio? Or television?
I'm afraid not.
Would you permit your work to be adapted for the screen, now that even E.M. Forster's been done?
Well, I prefer not to be done.
But he's been done rather well, don't you think?
Well, I've no idea. Been to the pictures for quite some time.
Two.
One.
Hey, are you sure this is the right window, man?
I don't know about this, Corey. What if we get caught?
We're not gonna get caught, jerk off. And any minute now, that room is gonna be filled with butt-naked babes.
Right.
Hey, big guy, give me the camera.
Oh, man.
Get off.
She is so totally hot!
Hey, someone's coming!
What? Christ, it's a stomper!
I'm out of here!
What are you boys doing here? You shouldn't be here!
This isn't the Air Force.
Hey, man! You got a rival! Molly's in there with a gun!
What?
I'll kill him!
Come on, let's go!
Mikey! You've been beaten to it by your kid brother!
I think it's time for a pizza delivery, boys.
Go get him, man!
Hey, what are you doing?
Oh, yes.
Cut it out!
Go, dude, go! Kick his ass!
Corey!
We can talk about this.
Yeah? Hey, Molly. What's happening, baby?
Hi, Corey. Come on, man. Put me down. Put me down.
Corey, she made me do it.
Shut up, you little jerk off. You're just trying to make me jealous, huh?
What a relief. My wife must have known this would happen. Tell me, Mrs. Reed, you live here alone now, don't you?
Yes, me alone.
But the television?
The television? It's mine. I like it.
You watch the pictures.
Your specialized subject is Christopher Columbus. You have 2 minutes starting. Now, by what name was Columbus known in Spain?
Cristobal Colón.
Correct. Of what did Columbus reputedly become the first European connoisseur?
Tobacco.
Correct.
How extraordinary. Columbus...
Have you been locked out all day?
No. Just for a short while. I went to the pictures. The cinema.
I'm ever so sorry about yesterday.
And why is that?
About not being home when you needed the keys.
Well, I can hardly dictate what you do on your Sundays, Mrs. Barker.
My sister in Whitstable's been poorly. Needs a bit of helping out.
Is there anything else, Mrs. Barker?
I was just going to mention... my sister and I heard you on the wireless yesterday.
Tell me, you weren't taught by Forster when you were up at Cambridge?
Alas, no.
You know they're even adapting his work for the pictures now? Can't say that I approve.
It could have been a lot worse.
The adaptation?
The interview.
Oh, in what way?
Could have been on television. That's a much greater intrusion, I can tell you.
Do you know you can get televisions that transcribe what people say?
Be another book?
Yes, I'm afraid it is.
I don't know how you do it. It takes me all my time to read one.
Well, as Gwen always used to say, it's easier to write one than it is to read one properly, Mrs. Barker.
Yes, I'm sure she did. I can almost hear her saying it.
I never really approved of the Pre-Raphaelites. Well, just look at him.
He's one of your sister's favourites.
What's meant to be going on? Love letters, suicide, that sort of thing.
More likely to be rejections from publishers. Chatterton was a writer.
I must get around to reading one of your books, Giles. Never seem to be enough hours in the day. Giles?
Winsome, young, neoclassical, isolated by beauty, death.
No smoking, Gov, thanks very much.
I beg your pardon?
It says no smoking.
No, it says thank you for not smoking. As I am smoking, I don't expect to be thanked.
Can I help you?
One for number three, please.
Come again?
One adult for number three.
What do you want to see, sir?
The film in number three.
Which?
Hot Pants College 2.
Thank you.
In town, that's what.
Oh, I wish you'd keep your mind on school, Corey, like your brother.
Yeah, yeah.
He finds time to work at Chicken Burger. Why can't you?
Mom, I thought you were going to see a doctor about that.
Bostock. R. Bostock, Esquire. Bostock. Brackets Ronald. Hot Pants College 2. Puerile romp without a single redeeming feature.
You wouldn't have any milk left, I suppose.
Mum, milk.
UHT?
UHT.
Only this left. Is okay?
It is milk, isn't it?
Abigail, we're closed now.
We're closing now.
Soon on video, Hot Pants College 2 has even more yummy guys than HC1, including mega dreamboat Ronnie Bostock. Next month, find out how Bosty fares in our feature on Hollywood's most snoggable fellas. Exclamation mark, exclamation mark, exclamation mark.
Disturb you, but I can't find them anywhere.
Mrs. Barker, I've been thinking that it would be best if I was left undisturbed in the afternoon. My work is very taxing at the moment.
What about your tea?
Oh, I'll call you when I'm ready for it, but I must admit it's been odd this last week.
It's that funny milk.
What is it you're looking for?
The kitchen scissors.
Is it on the left?
And what is your chosen specialized subject?
The life and work of Ronnie Bostock.
You have 2 minutes on the life and work of Ronnie Bostock, starting now. Ronnie Bostock was born in Southern California, but where does he live now?
Chesterton, Long Island.
Correct. What is the name of the dog which features prominently in his publicity stills?
Strider.
Correct. What is Ronnie Bostock's favorite reading material?
Stephen King and science fiction.
Correct. For what does Ronnie have a self-confessed weakness?
Pizza?
Yes, I'll accept it. It's actually pizza with extra anchovies. Under what circumstances would Ronnie do a nude scene?
If it were tasteful.
And
Essential to the plot.
Correct. Why was it not cast in the original Hot Pants College?
Too young.
No, he was unable to break his contract with the sitcom Home Is Where the Heart Is. What is Ronnie's favourite kind of training shoe and why?
Reeboks, because British stuff is cool.
Correct. With which of his rock idols was he recently photographed?
Axl Rose.
Correct. Ronnie claims to like nothing better than hanging out with the guys. What exactly do these guys mean to him?
I wonder.
Is that Chesterton there?
Chesterton. You want?
Why not?
For a change, yes?
Thank you.
I have, as usual, said you're far too busy. But it is a very prestigious lecture, Giles.
Would you advise me against it?
As your agent, I would strongly urge you to do it. But as a friend, I wouldn't want to disturb your work, which seems to be so invigorating, Giles.
I'll think about it.
Really?
Yes, I'm getting rather tired of hearing myself say no. Now, you can help me, Henry. What exactly is a sitcom?
Chip, go tell your father he's taking you bowling tonight.
Oh, Mom, why can't I ever give him good news?
Because I tell him that myself.
Hi, Dad.
Hi, Chip. How you doing?
Good. So, how about bowling tonight?
Bowling? Oh, boy.
What's wrong?
Not good. This program.
Root here,
yeah, this is better. Dog.
Nat here, age 9. The two most
you like dogs, Mr. Darth?
And I think on form, the two best. It's going to be a really good final.
Need any help, sir?
Yes, I'm interested in acquiring a video player.
These are microwaves, sir.
Oh.
Video players are over here. Let's start with this little humdinger. It's got it all, this one. Nikam digital stereo, long play facility, 14-day 8-event timer, 2-speed slow motion.
My needs are rather limited.
It's top of the range, this one.
Oh. Is it?
Yeah, and it's in your interest to keep up with the technology.
I'll get it, Mrs. Barker.
Delivery for Dr. De'Ath?
Yes.
Is that your real name, then?
Pronounced De'Ath.
Bet you get a lot of jokes.
Not since school.
Nice place. All these books. They're all different, are they? You read them all?
Yeah, could we,
Right. Where's your telly?
I'm sorry?
Gogglebox. TV.
No, I don't have one.
Blimey. What the hell's this for, then?
Well, it's to watch films on, actually.
Yeah, but what are you going to watch them on?
Well, on the video?
Two pieces of identification, one proof of address. I believe that qualifies me for membership.
There's a £10 deposit, so you don't nick nothing. But you get a £2 voucher for Bernie's Pizza delivery. You can take out 2 tapes now if you want.
Could I forfeit my Bernie's Pizza voucher for a 3rd one?
That's out.
I'm sorry.
Tex-Mex. Went out an hour ago.
Really?
We only keep one of everything unless it's a big fuck-off blockbuster.
I see.
That's in. Harry! Skid marks!
No, tape's buggered.
Do you want to have another bash?
Well, perhaps you would have Hot Pants College too?
Harry! Hot pants!
1, 2.
It's not out yet, is it?
Nah. Got hot pants 1 in.
May I place a reservation for Tex-Mex?
Oh, there's no reservations.
You mean I'd have to wait 2 weeks?
I hope not. You can only keep them out overnight.
Isn't one allowed 2 weeks at a library?
It takes 2 weeks to read a book, doesn't it?
Those things are more trouble than they're worth, if you ask me.
Mrs. Barker. I've been thinking I should be starting to cope a little better on my own. So I won't be needing you after 2 o'clock in the afternoons.
But what about your dinner?
Oh, I'm quite sure that I can manage. Oh, and I would prefer it if you didn't clean in this room at all.
What about the dust?
The more one dusts, the more dust one makes. That's what Gwen always used to say, Mrs. Barker.
Better work.
Cool it, Pete. Have I ever let you down before?
Just make sure you land him in this shit. That's what he's gone and done to us.
Hey, here he comes. Here he comes. Get down. Get down.
Now. Wow. Awesome.
Oh, shit.
Too darn right, bozo. You're in deep shit, all right.
Yeah, man. You know what you are? You're nothing but a skid mark on the underpants of life. Yeah.
He's coming.
So if you take the inverse of the object stuff,
yes,
so
seriously.
To have a theme, Henry. It would be the discovery of beauty where no one ever thought of looking for it.
Ah, yes. Familiar territory for you.
Hardly. I have begun to engage in completely new subject matter. New to me, at least.
Splendid. At our time of life, it's good to tackle something new. I was considering golf, actually.
I could almost say that it has brought me into contact with everything that I myself have never been. But that must be all for the time being, Henry.
Giles, I'm very intrigued.
You may find it rather difficult to get in touch with me in the near future.
I'm finding it rather difficult now, old chap.
Hey, Jake!
Hey, what's going on? Are you crazy?
Hey, get out of the way, Johnny.
This ain't the way, Jake. You heard what Father Bryson said. He said we all gotta learn how to get along.
Yeah? Well, I'm tired of these Mexicans taking jobs from my folks.
You never took any job you want and you know it.
Well, last time, just get out of the way, Johnny.
I ain't going anywhere. You want to get to these boys, you're gonna have to go through me.
Is that right?
Yeah, that's right. Corre, amigos, corre! Oh.
Oh, you did it now, Jake. Oh.
Save your breath, my child.
I tried to tell him, Father. I tried.
Hush, no. God knows what you say is true, to be sure.
You're right, Father. We all gotta try to live together. I'll never forget what you said.
Johnny?
No!
I promise you won't die in vain, my child. May the Lord have mercy on your soul.
For is it not the case that when we are in the habit of viewing a film more than once, assisted by that technological aid memoir, the video player, then a remarkable phenomenon presents itself. We see that what at first appeared to be merely accidental or unrehearsed becomes, on subsequent viewings, an indelible part of the film's texture. A distant landscape, a blurred face in the crowd, even a banal message on a T-shirt. So, the largely unrecognized art of film acting depends entirely on the ability of the actor, or indeed actress, to make everything about himself, or herself, seem equally permanent. When thus an actor is called upon to smile, he must try to select a smile from a collection, a repertoire, a whole file of smiles, as it were. Naive, rueful, sly, sarcastic. And so on. Anyway, to return to my theme of the death of the future.
Don't you think you've been overdoing it, Ultra? We're not as young as we used to be, after all. Maybe you should take a break. Go on a trip. Do you the world of good.
A trip?
Yes, I know you think that travelling for its own sake is frivolous, but I must insist that you seriously consider it.
This is Giles De'Ath speaking. If your call is extremely urgent, you may leave a brief message after I've finished speaking.
Good Lord. Giles, it's Henry. You have an answer phone. Whatever next?
Isn't there a guest house or something of that nature?
Well, no, there's a motel.
A motel?
Yeah, on the expressway.
Oh, no, that would be out of the question.
The room is quiet.
We take a pride in the secluded nature of our accommodation. How long will you be with us?
At least a week or two.
Are you touring Long Island?
No, not really.
A writer. From London, too. Oh, my. Well, we're charmed to have you, Mr.
De'Ath.
Well, mister, anything you want to know about Chesterton, you just ask me.
You're looking very spiffy today. Sir, you're looking very spiffy today, very attractive.
Oh, thank you.
Has Lou taken your order yet?
I must admit, I'm having a little difficulty understanding the menu.
Get him a cup of coffee.
What would you recommend?
We do a great cheeseburger.
Oh, I think not.
The best hash browns you ever tasted?
That rather goes without saying.
There you are.
Thank you.
So, you're from England, huh?
Yeah.
You ever bumped into a fellow by the name of Stan Brickhouse?
I believe not.
An attractive man, average-sized hands. But he had breasts. Like a woman.
Very odd.
He's a nice person, though. You should look him up. Anyway, I'm Irv, by the way.
Hence, chef d'oeuvre.
You got it. Irving Buckmuller, at your service. This area here is very attractive. This is where a person like you should be staying.
It's secluded?
Oh, you love it. Yeah.
Where the odd celebrity might hide out, no doubt.
Exactly. And you know what? They all know Irv's. Every one of them knows Irv's. Right, Luke?
doing?
Good morning.
Hey, that's a great tie.
Thank you.
Hire detective. Bribe postman.
This is too much.
Yes, Mrs. Abbott, is there any possibility of your more short-term guests not having rooms next to mine? Well, yes, I do appreciate that. But I also value my own privacy. Yes, indeed. It is interrupting my work. Over here, you ask for the check and pay with a bill. In England, you ask for a bill and pay with a check.
Is that the truth?
Yes.
No shit.
A writer here from London, England. Likes words.
How you doing today?
Very well, thank you.
You live around here?
No, well, not yet, at least. I'm looking at property for sale.
You're moving to Chesterton?
Well, it's a possibility.
Great wheels, huh? Yeah. You know, you'd cover a lot more ground in a car.
Yes, I suppose I would. May I go on my way?
Sure. We just like to know what strangers are up to, that's all. You take care now.
Yes.
You are standing too close to this vehicle. Move away immediately. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Hello. Ah, Mrs. Abbott. Yes, a typewriter seems to have appeared in my room. Oh, very thoughtful of you. Cocktails? No, I'm afraid not. I have to be up at the crack of dawn.
Morning.
How are you doing?
What happened to your foot?
Oh, blister or two.
You take it easy now.
Hey, Strider, you go home now.
Strider.
Once called Tiffy.
Tiffy? What kind of, what is that? What's that, a pansy name?
Come on, Tiffy lived to be 15.
We're not talking about how long the dog lived.
Caesar.
We're talking about names.
There's a lot of Caesars around.
What about Spot? Spot, that's the name that everybody calls the dog, Spot.
The dog has no spots.
They all got spots.
No, sometimes they've got patches. Yeah. There's a difference between a patch and a spot. Then they call it patch or patchy or patch patches. If it's got stripes, they call it stripey.
That's stupid.
Or stripes.
Come on.
Why, do you want a dog, Giles? I can get you puppies for free.
No. I just heard some rather strange names, that's all. Is Strider common?
Rider?
Strider. I never heard of this. Strider.
Oh, sure.
Never heard of it.
Strider, Caesar, they're all a damn nuisance.
You never knew Tiffy.
Most dreadfully sorry. I do hope nothing's broke.
I guess not.
We just don't have things this size in England, you know. Rather tricky to control.
It's okay. Take it easy.
Oh, haven't we met?
I don't think so.
Ah, no. I've seen your photograph. Are you a film star?
Would you mind just leaving me alone?
Oh, no, of course. You're engaged to Abigail's idol.
I could really do without.
Oh, no. My godchild, Abigail, has a huge crush on this very young, promising American actor. And his name is Ronnie Bostock, isn't it? You made a very handsome couple.
What kind of books do you write?
Oh, I'm hardly a household name over here.
Are you working on one now?
Well, if I'm inspired by the soothing rustle of the Long Island surf, as your Walt Whitman put it.
I hope you have a great time.
Are you over for long?
Excuse me?
From Hollywood?
Oh, we live here.
Oh, really?
Ron's in L.A. right now. I just can't believe he's so big in England. I never knew that.
It's extremely kind of you.
This isn't Manhattan, you know. You can't just hail a cab.
Indeed.
Got a lot of groceries for someone staying at a motel?
Yes, I've always been rather vague about domestic arrangements, but I wanted to find out how Americans shop, what you eat, and so on. Actually, I can heartily recommend the cheeseburgers at Chez Dove.
Oh, God, you've been to that dive?
Well, perhaps you can recommend somewhere superior.
There's some great seafood places up the coast, but you gotta drive there.
Well, allow me to take you out for a spot of lunch.
I couldn't really.
Thank you for your kindness.
I don't think so.
Very impressive.
You're both very talented, my dear.
Thanks.
Well, you must give Ronnie tips, no doubt.
Tips?
Well, doesn't he have to do photographs for the fan magazines?
Photo shoots, tell me about it. He hates them.
Oh, seems rather good at it.
Sure, it's just, he thinks you can't be a teen idol if you're going to be a serious actor.
Oh, does he?
It's crazy. I mean, most of the actors I know wait tables.
Why would they do that?
I can't wait to tell him I've met a famous British writer who thinks he's got the look of a young Olivier, was it?
A little.
Should be writing us down. Hey, maybe you could do a script for him or something.
Well, I don't exactly write for the youth market, Audrey.
Oh, that's great. He's so sick of playing dumb kids. Oh, it's okay.
Hi, we're not home. Leave a message.
Hey, babe. Honey? I guess you're out. Again.
It's Ron.
You better not be having a good time without me. Things are pretty cool here. I'll talk to you later. Love you.
I'll call him later. Oh, Giles, I forgot. You can smoke here if you want. We don't, but... Giles? Are you okay?
Dear God, this is ridiculous.
It's incredible. He's seen all your work, and he says that you're really big in England. You just love him. He's so British, you wouldn't believe it. Screw you. He's old enough to be my father.
So, Ronnie will be back soon.
Uh-huh.
Do give him my regards.
Sure.
Tell him that I will be following his career with great interest.
Maybe you should tell him. I'd like him to meet you. I guess you're busy, though, with your writing.
Well, yes, I am, but...
Oh, I don't know. We're really busy, too. You can get kind of shy. I don't know. Maybe I'll call you.
Thank you.
So, Giles, he may not show it, right, but he really wants to hear what you told me about his potential.
Oh, really?
Really. He's been kind of low since he got back. If you could find some way of telling him what you think of him, well, I'd really appreciate it.
Well, what do you know? Here's the cops. They're keeping an eye on the place. One of the neighbors saw some weirdo hanging around.
Oh, yeah? Forgot to tell you.
Are you guys coming in or what? Come on, Strider.
It's nothing, really, okay, Giles. Here.
Shakespeare?
Oh, yes, his plays are full of it.
Well, wait a minute. Are you saying that if Shakespeare was alive today, he'd be doing things like Hot Pants College?
All I'm saying, Ronnie, is that Shakespeare used bawdy humor to please the mob in the pit.
I never knew that.
Yes, and of course he was able to elevate his material beyond such limitations. As have you. And I'm not talking about good acting as if it was, say, merely good cooking. Oh, by the way, the teriyaki was delicious.
Thanks.
I'm talking about a type of acting that is purely instinctive. You see, Ronnie, you have something that gives even the most casual look or gesture a real intensity.
Yeah?
Oh, yes. I mean, it came as no surprise to me when I heard that you'd been rescued at an early age from the hell of advertising. It was obvious to me that some producer, some astute producer, had seen what I saw when Abigail persuaded me to see Hot Pants College too.
Yeah, but the only reason I got that role is because I looked like the guy who played Mikey in the original.
Yes. But didn't you completely reinvent the character with a mere string of lines? Didn't you make Mikey the focus of the entire story?
Well, I wouldn't exactly say that.
As for your fate in the pizza parlor, the plastic tomato and all that, well... well, I don't know. This may sound absurd, but... No. My point of reference would be Wallace's painting of the tragic young writer Chatterton that hangs in the Tate Gallery.
I'd really like to see that.
But, Giles, we've seen Hot Pants in theaters with kids, and they don't get any of that.
Of course not.
But it's made for them.
But they're the rabble in the pit.
We saw Hot Pants at this drive-in used to be here. Ron kept his sunglasses on the whole time.
Giles, did you ever see Tex-Mex?
Oh, I did indeed. More than once.
Really killed me when that one bombed.
Ah, yes, I'm afraid it suffered the same fate in Europe.
I really believed in that project, you know, it had a real message.
Yes, it was a great shame, really. You see, in Europe, we have a much stronger tradition of work with what you call a message. Well, that is, after all, why I've been persuaded to write my first screenplay. Yes, if Tex-Mex had been, say, German, about the plight of the exploited Gastarbeiters, it would have met with a far greater success.
They have Mexicans in Germany?
It probably would have made less money than Hot Pants, but then you see, in Europe, we're not necessarily interested in that kind of a success. Not when a film can change the way people think. And that, Ronnie, is why I write. It's also why you act, although you may not yet know it.
You married or something?
I was. My wife died unexpectedly some time ago.
Sorry to hear that. Got any kids?
No, no. My wife was rather older than myself.
Oh, like me and Odd.
Yes, indeed.
So what's this script about?
Script?
Yeah, you said you were working on a screenplay.
Oh, yes, that. Oh, I couldn't subject you to work in progress.
Why not?
And then, of course, there is the risk of copyright infringement.
What?
Charles, we're old friends, huh?
Well, coffee always takes her forever.
Indeed.
Hey, Strider.
So what's it about?
Well, it concerns a young man, Ronnie. About your age, I suppose. He's a deaf mute, brought up in complete isolation. His only human contact is through the television. So he has been subjected to rather excessive and unrealistic types of behavior.
He never speaks.
Oh, he cannot speak.
Wow.
Oh, yes, I'm determined that the audience share his subjective state rather than merely pity him, because, well, that would be awful.
Yeah. So what happened?
Understandably enough, he yearns to enter the real world. So he surrenders himself to the most irrational desire known to mankind. Maybe you can guess what that is. It is the desire to fall in love, Ronnie. And since he's been exposed to such a thing on the television every day, it becomes his quest, so to speak. And every tale, whether it be Richard III or Hotpants College III, centers upon a quest. And as in my other work, it will inevitably end with a sacrifice. The French in particular seem to like such a thing. However, I suspect it is not one for the drive-ins. Oh, thank you, my dear. Decaf au lait, no doubt?
Uh-huh.
Thanks, Brad.
It's brilliant, man.
Oh, I don't think so. Not yet, at least.
Oh, it is. I've never heard a storyline like that. I'm totally blown away.
It's very kind of you.
It's kind of artsy, I guess.
Oh, dear. Is that bad?
No. That's good. Have you seen Birdie?
Birdie?
Birdie, yeah. It's an Alan Parker film. I met him once. He's from England, too. Oh, it's just a fax. Probably more rewrites.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
You can smoke, Charles.
You smoke?
Oof.
Bad habit,
oh,
man.
Yes, I know.
We'd never have met if he didn't.
Really? Why is that?
Giles chose to stay in Chesterton because he smokes Chestertons.
Cool.
Giles. You know what you were saying about being a writer and wanting new experiences and all? I don't know, maybe it's not such a good idea.
Come on, tell us, babe.
Well, I was just thinking, I have a shoot in the city tomorrow and I just thought maybe you'd like to come.
They're so boring.
Not necessarily, not if you haven't been on one.
Well, I'm not coming.
I'm not inviting you.
And totally boring, Giles.
Wouldn't I be in the way?
I'd love you to come. I'm sure you'd get some great ideas.
I got a better idea. Why don't I show you the Hamptons?
You don't like the Hamptons.
I do off-season. What do you say?
It's such a choice. One couldn't do both.
No way. Okay, I'll tell you what. If the weather's okay, we'll go to the coast. If it's raining, you go into the city with the supermodel here.
Well, that does sound fair.
Okay, babe?
Mm-hmm.
exit out in the corner. Head man's the park.
So, things look good for Washington and Baltimore tomorrow. It's a different story in New York. Just look at those clouds gobbling up Manhattan. They're sure to bring rain tomorrow, and plenty of it. Over in Long Island, it's going to be even worse, with both coasts pulling in that low pressure.
Hey, dude, how's it hanging?
It's cool.
Hey, man, I'm real sorry about your mother. Life's a bitch, huh?
Yeah, I guess. You know something, Brad? I just wish I could have made things easier for her.
Yeah?
Yeah. It seemed like she was always working and stuff. Never really got a chance to know her.
Hey, man, don't grief out on me.
Sorry, man. Just feeling a bit lonesome, you know?
Hey, you're a college boy now. All those babes don't want to see you lonesome.
Sure. Like I'm Mr. Popular.
Well, I'm going to make you Mr. Popular. And that's a promise. A poignant little scene.
Yeah, it sets up the whole storyline, see? I go to college, all the college girls try to mother me, but I fall in love with a teacher whose husband turns out to be a grand wizard in the KKK.
Something of a message there?
That's the usual stuff.
Tell me, do you get a chance to deliver a eulogy to your mother?
No way. It would hold up the action.
You're allowed to improvise?
Thanks, babe. They get pretty nervous about that.
What's the point?
Where you been hiding yourself?
I was talking to our neighbor. Is that okay?
Is this one of those telephones that doesn't have to be plugged in? Quite remarkable, isn't it?
Hey, I have a great idea. Giles, why don't you call your godchild in England?
I'm sorry?
Abigail, wasn't it? You could call her and tell her you're sitting here with Ronnie Bostock and Ron could say hi to her. I know she'd just die.
Well, I'm afraid it's the middle of the night in England.
We're only 5 hours ahead.
You know what, Odd? It's about the stupidest idea I ever heard. What am I supposed to say to the kid, huh? I'm sorry, Giles. Jesus.
Ronnie. Brackets at his mother's grave, end of brackets. I'd like to say a few words by Walt Whitman, if that's okay with everyone.
I'd like to say a few words by Walt Whitman, if that's okay with everyone. The untold want by life and land never granted.
Yeah, sure.
Now, Voyager, sail thou forth to seek and find.
I suspect you're going to have to explain the rules to me.
Okay. You gotta hit the ball and run round the bases to home.
Hence, baseball. Rather like circular cricket.
I guess.
Is there something wrong, Audrey?
We're going to see my folks tomorrow, up in Vermont.
Vermont?
For a week.
For a week?
Before Ron has to go back. That's a strike, Giles.
To, Los Angeles?
Right.
Ronnie never mentioned this.
He doesn't know yet.
You understand that we still have a lot of work to do on the script.
It's too bad. I guess he'll get by. That's a strike too, Giles.
Audrey, surely it is as clear to you as it is to me that he deserves a great deal more than getting by.
He'll do it this time. He never gets struck out. Watch us, Giles. It's going to be a good one. The bases are loaded.
You realize this is a very crucial moment in his life.
God, you're good. That's a home run, Giles.
Ronnie.
So, this is your last day in Long Island. Or should one say, on Long Island.
Yeah, well, it's getting kind of itchy, so.
I'm also leaving Long Island soon.
Really? Well, we should hook up in Europe sometime.
I'd like that. Ronnie, I'd like that very much. Of course, you must honor your obligations to Audrey, though it strikes me that you're very young to be making such a commitment, especially with your career at this crucial stage.
Yeah, well, guy's got to know when he's onto a good thing, right? It's like that for you, wasn't it?
I suppose so, yes.
It's, birthmark.
They cover it up for shooting, but I like it.
You know, I always thought it was on the right.
How do you mean?
Ronnie, I have a confession to make to you. I've been waiting for you for quite some time.
Oh, shit, Giles, I'm sorry.
Several
I had to drop
years,
out.
Years, in fact.
What?
Ronnie, there is nothing more solitary than an artist's life. No doubt you'll find that out for yourself. Painfully, perhaps. One yearns for solace without quite knowing where to look for it. But I found it in you.
That's great.
Ronnie, I have another confession to make. I brought you here not to say goodbye, but to make you an offer.
An offer?
I am prepared to devote myself to your career.
Wow. Giles, I'm honored. I don't know what to say. You gotta come out west. We can start to work on something.
No, Ronnie. Forget Los Angeles. Put it behind you. Your future lies in Europe.
Giles, I gotta take things one step at a time. I mean, sure, Odd'd love to go back to Europe and do some more work, and it would be cool to spend some time there.
Cool? I'm talking about a turning point in your life.
But I've got no contacts there. People know me here.
As what, Ronnie? As what?
Look, we'll keep in touch, huh?
Listen to me, Ronnie. In Europe, it is often the case that a young man benefits from the wisdom and the experience of an elder. Why, there's almost a tradition of such friendships. Cocteau, Radiguet, Verlaine, Rambo.
Rambo?
Arthur Rambo, French poet. He was Paul Verlaine's lover.
Look, Giles, I really gotta go. I gotta pick up Odd, and I don't want to...
No, listen. No, I understand your misgivings. And I respect the fact that your immediate plans are founded on these temporary attachments.
Temporary attachments?
Well, Ronnie, your relationship with Audrey is hardly likely to last forever.
And why is that?
Well... I'm afraid it's obvious to me.
What exactly are you trying to say, Giles? Look, Giles, I would like to believe all of the things that you said about my career, but you got things all wrong.
Ronnie, listen to me. You don't understand.
Giles, I think I do understand, and I have to go now.
No, how can you act like this? When you know, you must know how completely, how desperately I love you.
What have I got?
I wonder if you could do me a great favor and add this to your deliveries.
I don't know if I can do that, sir. It's a federal offense.
Sure.
I'm sorry, sir.
My dear Ronnie, it is so difficult to know where I should begin. Especially when, unlike you, I already know the ending. But let us say that this story began with the end of another, far, far from the surf of Long Island.
Tell me, when one sends a fax, is it possible for it to be reversed?
What do you mean, sir?
Well, can it be got back?
I don't know about that.
I imagine not.
You want to turn back?
I think it's rather late for that.
You sure?
Quite sure, thank you.
Well, Ronnie, there it is, the end of our story. And also the beginning of a new story for me. But perhaps you've worked that out for yourself. But what of you, my darling?
for no one on earth knows you better than I do. And if you've read thus far, I know you'll never bring yourself to destroy this letter, nor will you ever show it to anyone else. And it will gradually dawn on you that your life might have taken a very different course had you simply been able to open your heart to another. And you'll often return to this letter. You'll read it again and again in the years to come, until you no longer have to read what you know by heart. And you'll cherish it as a source of pride in the face of an uncaring world.
I'd like to say a few words by Walt Whitman, if that's okay with everyone. Now finale to the shore. Now land and life. Finale and farewell. The untold want by life and land never granted. Now voyager, sail thou forth to seek and find.
The streets are dark and cold. Along the huts about to unfold. The neon lights are flashing by. A stranger's voice is whispering why. We'll never stop, we'll never give in. Our fire burns like a violin. We'll keep on playing until the end. A rock and roll will never bend. We're living fast, we're living loud. Our hearts are beating like a drumming crowd. We are the rebels, we are the ones. Our music echoes like a thousand guns. We're driving down the open road. Our spirits high, our passion glowed. We're chasing dreams that seem so far. We're raising hell like shooting stars. We'll never stop, we'll never give in. Our fire burns like a violin. We'll keep on playing, we'll keep on playing until the end. A rock and roll will never bend. We're living fast, we're living loud. Our hearts are beating like a drumming crowd. We are the rebels, we are the ones. Our music echoes like a thousand guns. We'll never stop, we'll never stop. We'll never stop, we'll never stop. We're living fast, we're living loud. Our hearts are beating like a drumming crowd. The rebels, we are the ones. Our music echoes like a thousand guns. We're living fast, we're living loud.
to be.